Hi guys, today I am going to tell you a new technique. It is a reverse engineering of a software. Let us see what is it. What is a reverse engineering? Reverse engineering is a technique used to reverse the software and test the software. This is used by the developers to test the software and modify it, and we can use it for skipping the product key registration, which is most useful for us. Let us see how to do it. I'm going to take an example for a power achiever software, which is used to achieve your file and encrypt your file and etc. You may know what is it. Let us see. Sorry. Here it is. Let us install it first. After installing, it asks for a enter registration code. As we enter something and click OK, it gives a pop-up message that our registration code is incorrect, and here is the key for us to skip this process and get the full access of the software. Just note the incorrect registration information. It will be useful in later to crack the software. Close everything. Now we are going to use a OLI debugger, which is used to debug the software and test your software. Run it as an administrator. Close everything before we start. It will look like this when you open it. File open and go to the C drive where you have been saved your file and program x64 and power achiever. Inside the power achiever, we are going to open the exe file executable. In case the power arc is my exe file, I am opening it. These are the assembly language code for the software developed, and these are the hexadecimals of this to understand by the computer these days, and this is for us the users. Now we have to start the process, so just play and right click. Now go to search for all reference text file. Now keep your mouse pointer at the top. And right click, search for text, INCORRECT, incorrect, REGISTRATION, registration. This was the pop-up message we saw there, so we are just writing it and clicking OK. We get it to the place where the pop-up message occurs. Now in this we are going to double click it, and we are again redirected to the first box. In first box also we are finding the incorrect registration, and here we are now going to see the test AL, AL. Here is the test AL, AL. After test AL, AL, JNZ. Here what we are going to do is double click on it. JNZ we are changing to JMP, jump statement of the assembly language, which is going to just jump to the statement and no operation on the next line, then cancel. This will jump the registration process, and we need not to register our product, and we can use without registering full access we will get. Now we are again going to right click it, copy to executable, all modification. We are not going to use the original type of the software, we are just making a duplicate form of the software and we are going to use on it. So copy all. This was the copy of that new application. Right click it and save file. It asks where to save. Just save it on the same x64 program files and power arc and give a new name for it. I giving 2, 3 and saving it. That's all. We have been successfully done the crack. Now close everything. Now go to C drive, x64, power arc, then this was the file we have been created. Open it. Now we again ask for the enter registration code. Now we are going to enter something, ABC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and click OK. You are seeing registration accepted. Thank you for purchasing power arc. It just jumped the registration process and now we will get the full access of the software. This is a reverse engineering technique used by the software engineers and other developers. Thanks for watching.